God bless you. You are welcome to this serial teaching on How to Hear from God, Volume 2, with Pastor Emma Ejenwosu. In this serial teaching, you will know how to hear from God and how to recognize His voice. God bless you. Listen and be blessed.
Praise Master Jesus Christ. How to Hear from God, Volume 2. We have been talking about this subject, how do we hear from God? And I told you in Volume 1 that it is very natural thing for you to desire to hear God's voice. I also told you that you are a spirit being. You were constituted that way because you were made in God's image and God's likeness. So the things that God does, you are capable of doing. You are God in a smaller form here on earth. So that God being spirit, you also spirit, and you live in a body, you have a soul. Now that is something I want to hold very firmly to your heart. And so we're talking in Volume 2, what it is what we call some myths generally accepted about hearing the voice of God. Myths, M-Y-T-H-S. Some erroneous views, some things people hold as truth or as fact that have not been substantiated. Some people call it conspiracy theory. That's the modern word is used for now. Myths. And we'll look at some of these things. And when you have these wrong notions about hearing from God, they are likely to be a hindrance to you from flowing to hear God speak to you. Like I told you, you are constituted that way. You have to learn how to exercise the organs you have, the spiritual organs, sense organs, so you can relate with God. You are packed that way. You can hear God's voice. God wants to speak to you. It is His pleasure. You are not begging God to talk to you. So if you are not able to hear from God, it means that something is wrong on your side. Job 33, verse 14, the Bible there said, God speaks. And if you go through the Bible, you see many instances, God speaking to Noah, speaking to Moses, speaking to Elisha, and other people in the New Testament. So one of the myths that have hindered people from developing themselves to hear God is, God does not talk to people today as in the olden days. This is not true. I myself have had God. In fact, I'm alive today, and the rest of my ministry today is because of the things God have said to me. Every day I rely upon Him for direction, and not I alone. There are a whole lot of people who rely upon God for everyday guidance. But when you erroneously accept this myth that today God don't talk to people anymore, I want to see that what it's in the Bible, that Bible is a collection of things that God that happened in the past. And recorded by the Holy Spirit with two authors. Now, in some places, you see that two verses can have an account of 50 years. So when the Bible says, God said to him, it may not be that God begins to speak every second. And the Bible account are different accounts of God dealing with many of His servants. So God still speaks to people today. And I can tell you that after you follow this series, you will be in the number of people that God speaks to. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Number two, a spiritual believer do not need to understand the meaning of their dreams today. Because you will later be talking about that. Dreams is one of the ways that God speaks to us. That Job 33 from verse 14. He said, now God speaks and man does not perceive it. He said, in a dream, in a vision of the night. Some people have totally locked themselves and say, oh, all those things you hear about dreams, all those things you hear about visions and revelations, they don't work today anymore. If you have this kind of wrong understanding, wrong notion, it's going to be a hindrance in you connecting to God. Remember, I told you in Volume 1 that you have these sense organs, but it is your place to develop these sense organs to function. But if you have lied to yourself, you have accepted an error that those sense organs are not there and they are not working, then there's no way you can exercise them and grow in your spiritual life. Number three myth I mentioned here is, God does not speak to sinners. This also is not true. It is not true. Bible said in Genesis chapter 4 that God spoke to Cain. Cain was the murderer. After he had killed his brother, God spoke to him. Bible recorded in the book of Genesis that God spoke to Laban, the uncle and father-in-law to Jacob, the trickster, the manipulator, the deceiver. God spoke to Laban. Bible also recorded that God spoke to Nebuchadnezzar. If you look at your Bible in Daniel chapter 2, Bible said that God gave a revelation through a dream. In Genesis 20, from verse 1, we saw God speaking to a man called Abimelech, who God took Abraham's wife. He was a Gentile. He was not a Christian. He was not a pastor, as knowing today. Bible has many accounts that God speaks to sinners. Why dealing with this is important is because some people believe that they are sinners. And because they are sinners, that God will not speak to them. No, God speaks to sinners. It depends on where you are in your position, and that depends on what God will tell you. Number 4, God must speak directly to us into our own very ears before we consider it as authentic. Now, these are people who you tell, this is what God is telling you. This is what God is telling us. This is the will of God for this matter. And they say, no, I want to hear a thunder blast from heaven. In this study, we're going to see that not everybody that God spoke to, God shout from heaven. There are many ways that God used to speak to people. In some account, you see that here that God speak to, said something to David. In other account, it was through the priest that were escorting him, and that priest, through what is called Urim and Thummim, will tell David the will of God. Another time, a prophet called Gad, he called him David seer, we can't come and tell David, look at what God is saying to you. As it is in the New Testament, it's in the Old Testament. You saw in Acts chapter 20, when Agabus said to Paul, this is what God is saying. So you must not hear from heaven, but you need to know the different ways that God speaks to his people. So if you have a wrong notion, wrong idea of what it is to hear God speak to you, you are likely going to have a problem in getting God talk to you. Number 5, God can use even witch doctors and diviners to communicate to us. This also is an error. As we saw in 1 Samuel 28, the spirit in a person gives the person unction, utterance. If you go to a witch doctor, the spirit in the witch doctor is from the devil. If you go to a mummy without priestess or an occult person, those people can mislead you. The spirit in them cannot lead you to serve the only true God, Jehovah. And some people who believe this, and so they resort to going to any kind of place. They say, God created heaven and earth, all these people belong to God. No, brother. God condemns people who go to sorcerers, go to witches and wizards and occult people. There's a clear cut channel that God has laid down to talk to his children. And if you develop yourself as a person and you connect to Jesus Christ, who is the way, you try the life, God can help you develop your spirit person. You too can hear from God. Bible said Isaiah chapter 8, I think that verse 19 says, why inquire of the living from the dead? So you don't go to the dead to get message for the living. You are a living child of God. God can speak to you. Number 6, God only gives a second chance and then he leaves you to perish. This is a notion of some people. They say, oh, God spoke to me some years back. I did obey him. He spoke again. I did not obey him. So now he's true with me. That's why I'm not hearing him anymore. It is not true. In 1 Samuel chapter 3, 1 to 14, Bible recorded that God called Samuel 4 times. He called him the first time, he didn't understand him. Called him the second time, he did not understand him. Third time, until the fourth time, when Eli told him how to answer. In the book of Jonah, chapter 1, Bible said that God spoke to Jonah. In chapter 2, God also called to Jonah. And another one, chapter 3, God also spoke to Jonah. So what I'm going to make you understand is that God wants to keep relationship with you. So don't believe that lie. So people have that kind of wrong notion. If there was some time God was speaking to you and you lost the voice of God, no longer hearing from him, it's important you find out what is hindering you from hearing God's voice. And when you deal with that thing and put that out of the way, you can begin to hear the voice of God again. Number 7, God only reveals things to his prophets. And these are people who are also claiming to be super people. And each time you want to hear from God, you go to look for major prophet one, major prophet two, or major prophet three. You travel from place to place. This is not true. The Bible reveals that in Daniel chapter 2, that God spoke to Nebuchadnezzar. He was not God's prophet. God spoke to Abimelech in Genesis chapter 20. He was not God's prophet. There are many people instances in the Bible. In fact, in Matthew 27, the wife of Potiphar received a message that I thought we must attribute to have come from God. There are people in the Bible, you know, that God spoke to them. They are no super prophets. But I can say that it was the student that became a teacher. So, somebody that is nobody in the kingdom of God can hear the voice of God and grow up, like we said earlier, that God, what is we need to hear from God is to get divine direction if God is calling us into the ministry. So your relationship with God can start one day and God will begin to speak to you. But it is not true that you must be Superman, you must be very spiritual, you must attempt at land before God speaks to you. I can tell you that as I'm sharing this with you now, it is God that is speaking to your heart, and you will do well if you yield yourself and see where or what God is trying to make you understand. Number 8 says God only talks to people today through the Bible. This also is an error. I am an author. I've written a number of books, and I know some wonderful men of God who have gone to be with the Lord. It is only a dead man that has everything he has to say in a book. As an author, I'm still writing books. But as our brother, wonderful author, Miles Muro, he has got to be with the Lord. All he has to say are in his books. Another great man of God, T. Austin Sparks, he has got to be with the Lord. So you can get his view from his books. But I am still alive. I am still talking. So Bible is a manual. If you go to buy a gadget, you buy it's not like a computer, but like a smartphone or even a car. They put a manual, a booklet inside the machine you bought. And that manual will guide you on how to use that equipment. Now, if you take your phone from Nigeria and you go to USA, if you read your manual very well, it will tell you what to do when you get to USA. It's still applicable. But the networks in Nigeria and USA and China, they are different. Just like television. If you have television, you go to another country, the channels are different. But the manual will tell you how to use them in different places. So the Bible is the manual guiding the child of God on the right way to live his life as a Christian. He gives you examples of how other believers like you have lived their life and how they didn't do right or they did wrong. It gives you guidance. So God is still speaking today beyond the Bible. But God cannot tell you something that is outside what he has said in the Bible. The Bible tells you a pattern, a format of the kind of things that God says. Verse number 9. We don't need someone to guide us in hearing God's voice. This is also an error. In Acts chapter 20, verse 28, and a man called Agabus was trying to speak to Paul. Say, Paul, this place you're going to is not the will of God for you. You want to get into a problem. Paul defiantly disobeyed that instruction. He went to Jerusalem and he spent 2 years in prison. He almost died there. And that God can use other people to talk to you, to guide you, no matter how spiritual you are. In fact, one wonderful example is between Moses and his father-in-law, Jethro. Moses heard from God. Moses prayed and raised his prayer. But Jethro spoke to him so that he could give him direction. God can speak to you through other people. God speaks to you through other men of God. You can give guidance, even though you are spiritual. You can get confirmation of what God is saying to you through them. But if you have this error in you that God must speak to you, that or only what God tells you is acceptable, then such people always fall into error. And when they are having crisis, there's no way to recover them. Number 10, we should not bother ourselves about hearing God speak to us. If we don't hear him, he will speak where he wants to. Now, this is an error. Some say, okay, he's not speaking to me, so I shouldn't bother about it. If you want to speak to me, then you could call my attention. For me now, he's not speaking. Let me just go live my life. It is not a right choice to make. It's an error. God is speaking to you. There are many ways that God speaks. God is devised many ways to call your attention. God does not want you to perish. God uses many methods, even as an unbeliever. There are many ways God preached to you. Personally, I did not repent for somebody preached to me. I believe that people pray for me, but in preaching to me, I went to church myself. But when I got there, people I met there, God used them to give me direction. God was calling me because I was not getting him. That Job 3, verse 14, he said, God speaks. So if you're not getting God, it's like I went into the office, into the house of one of my friends. He's a minister. I didn't know he had had hearing. And so I called him. He did not answer. He was reading. I shouted, no answer. I walked away in anger. Later, I discovered that my friend was having hard hearing. He was not hearing well. So if you are not hearing God well, it means you're having hard hearing. Something is blocking your flow with God. So you need to take away that thing. Don't accept it as status quo. 11, mature and highly spiritual people do not need other believers to assist them to get the full meaning of what God is saying. This also is an error. When you are matured and you are grown, you cannot grow to the point where you don't need other people balancing you. As long as we're on this earth, we saw what we mentioned earlier about Paul and Agabus in Acts 20, verse 28. There are instances when people will be doing something and they need other believers to confirm. So, in fact, one evidence that God is talking to you and you are matured is that when the Lord is speaking to you, you are willing to put it on the table for every believer to see, everyone to know that this is from God. Even when people don't agree with you, those people teach that don't let people get see your dream. And they are always quoting the account of Joseph when his brother tried to give, when he told them he had a dream. I want to tell you that the dream that Joseph had there wasn't a dream of a vision. It wasn't him, he slept and he got up. That was it. That Joseph's brothers have behaved wrongly, but you go to the Bible, you see instances where other people help people to position themselves in what God was saying to them. So, no matter how highly placed you are, we still need one another. And I pray that God will help you understand this in Jesus' name. 12, God does not speak to women. This is a total error. God speaks to women. If you look at the book of Judges, chapter 5, God spoke to Deborah. And somewhere in the Second Chronicles, we meet a woman called Huldah. She was a contemporary of the man of God called Jeremiah. The Bible called her a prophetess. And that means God spoke to her. And we there are other instances in the Bible. The mother of Samson, the wife of Manoah, the angel of the Lord came and spoke to her. God speaks to women. This is a wrong idea. If you're a woman and you're hearing me today, I want you to know that God speaks to women. 13, we must be on fast and in a quiet place before we can hear God's voice. Even though I encourage you to fast, even I encourage you to create an atmosphere for God to speak to you, but God can speak to you in the midst of a noisy market. You only need to know how to exercise yourself and how to know when God is calling your attention. Anywhere you are, remember you are created in his image and likeness. You have the nature, so he can always reach you. You only need to know when God is calling your attention. 14, God cannot speak to a man outside his leader. These are people, opinion people hold, that it must come from your papa or from your bishop. Let me tell you something. God speaks to everybody. God does not have grandchildren. But God does not endorse rebellion. God cannot keep you under a leader and ask to act against your leader. But in that first Samuel chapter 3, when God has spoken to Eli, and Eli was not obeying, was not walking in direction, God spoke to Samuel. And there are instances where God speaks to followers, expecting them to obey their leaders. God called Hagar, say, go back to your mistress. So God can speak to an underling. He can speak to a junior pastor, can speak to a church member, and that he will speak to you will always agree with the general vision that God has given to the person that is leading you. 15, great prophets of God in the Old and New Testament find it easy to hear God's voice. This also is not correct. 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 27. Bible said that when the woman of Shunem ran to come and see Elisha lamented that as woman was coming, that God had not told him that the woman had a problem, even though the woman was a partner to his ministry and her son had died. In Acts of the Apostles, chapter 16, from verse 1, Bible showed how Paul, that was earlier called Saul, was struggling to get divine direction from God as to what God wanted him to do. So, even every man of God you see, no matter how highly placed he is desiring to have relationship with God. Your walk with God is a relationship, is a father. You need to develop it. And it's at the pace you develop it. Unfortunately, I can say that when we begin to grow older as believers, God begins to know that we have come to a place we should know right from wrong. We have gone to a place which have matured and passed a particular level. So what God does is that he gives us a chance to operate as mature sons and daughters. And that is why at times it's like God speaks to new believers more than old believers. And I can tell you that out of experience. Most of the men of God and women of God that are older, you see them struggling, wanting to know what God is telling them. And when some people come up and they have this wrong notion that speaking to God or God hearing you should be very easy, and that's why people resort to medium. They go to mystic shops, get something so that they can begin to hear from the spirit. And most things they hear from the spirits are not from God, they are from the devil. Now, all these erroneous errors, erroneous views, what I call myths, are things that people believe. And when they believe it, it becomes a problem on their part to hear the voice of God. I want to thank God for bringing you to this conclusion of this volume 2. And I pray you look up for the volume 1. And I pray that God will bring you into revelation and open your spiritual eyes and your spiritual ears so you can begin to hear from God and understand God's voice. God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Remain under this anointing in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hope you are blessed through that teaching. Watch out for Volume 3. Pastor Emma is the International President of Prayer Network for Universal Revival and also the Rector of School for Deliverance and Spiritual Warfare. We have the online platform for those who are far away, Deliverance School Online. Contact us today with the contacts below. God bless you. Thanks for listening.